Seen that, Billy? It's another lovely day on the Costa.
Not from where I'm laying.
Oh, come on, Billy.
Not laying here all day. Maybe some fresh sea air might help.
If you're gonna walk down the beach, you can sort me out, eh, Charlie?
Come on, Billy, I ain't trying to help you. Take it easy.
Yeah, well, I want to know exactly why he thinks a bit of fresh air is going to change the fact that I put a man in a coma last night.
Twat.
Hey.
Go on, then, drag him out.
Get up, boys.
We're going to hit that truck.
On the beach. Apparently it'll do the trick.
Oh. At least he got out of bed.
We're out of wood. We need to go and chop some logs.
Chop some logs? How do we do that?
With an axe, you idiot.
Anyway, you're calling an idiot?
Well, there's only one person here who doesn't know how to chop logs.
Have I done so much to offend you, Charlie? Do you know how to chop logs?
Yeah, with an axe, you idiot.
Come on, Al. You've wrapped me three times already.
Yeah, well, these babies are my ticket to the big swim.
All right, girls.
There he is.
Where have you been? Getting your bottom spanked by staff?
No, raising funds to extract your broke ass from the gutter.
Yeah, all right.
A little risk-averse value. Three bags to up the ante.
$3,000.
Shit.
Fair play, Charlie boy.
Down there.
Billy, like I said, you wanted to...
Listen, just shut up and stand there, all right? Al, turn around.
You what?
Just do it. Okay, Charlie, back up a step. I'll do. Arse out, Albert.
Fuck off.
Listen, if the two of you are going to keep fighting like a couple of whiny kids, we're going to sort this out like we did when we were 12. Charlie's the offended party. So, by the laws the three of us set down, Charlie gets one free kick to Albert's arse. Hard as you like.
What is this? This is ridiculous.
Yeah, hold on. Maybe we might be onto something.
Come on, then. Let's get going.
All right, you know what? That's what it takes, OK? I'm prepared to face my sentence, right? One kick, Charlie.
This actually used to work.
Things were simpler back then.
For Christ's sake, turn around. You look absurd standing there like that.
Right, I should have told you, Charlie, okay? I just felt like I needed to think about how I wanted to handle it first, and I'm sorry, okay? I should have sought your advice.
No, maybe I was wrong. I should have known you weren't going to leave us all behind. So.
You've known the girl for 5 minutes.
There is no time, space, or motion in the matter of the heart. But not that you would know that, Billy, because yours is carved out of solid oak.
Yeah, you're damn straight. Ain't nothing in those fairy tales for me, mate.
What's that?
We've rung the bell. Charlie, can you bring the van round, please, mate?